Hello friends, this is Dr. Abhijit Singh Jadeja. To take a VP.NET tool label today, here I have Division C. Division C, there is a project. The project title is FOSS 13-1-21, matlab 13 January 2021. I'm just opening it. That Solution Explorer is loading in our screen, and in our screen, we are going to represent today the label tool. In VB.NET, there will be more than 20 to 25 tools we will study in this semester. So in front of us, there is a program about switch case and all that things we are completing last time. And the last video is also about switch case. Now today we are adding add new Windows form, add Windows new form. This is form 3, but I want to change the name of it. LABEL label example. So LABEL EX example. When I click on it, it is alphabetically order wise sorted. So I just increase this thing, and you know that one. In my project, A, B, C, D, same like that. After I, label example is there. So I would like to make a title change of this form. So I am moving to the property, and the name of property is text property. My dear friends, today, text property, and example of label. Fine. So first of all, there is a static property that I would like to perform in front of you about label, that is auto size property, and it is a very important and basic property. So I drag and drop one label is there, and please kindly concentrate in a property. And my screen right side, my cursor is moving. At that time, auto size property is true. You can see that. So what is the effect of auto size true and auto size false? Then after we are performing all the property as a dynamic level, runtime may all property, that all property will be changed automatically. Though first of all, auto size true, and I'm moving to the text. And in this text, I'm typing the definition about computer and something to write about computer. Computer is an electronic machine that perform not only numeric process, but it provide logical argument and make program to solve our various tasks. So when I type this, oh my god, that's a problem, that I type the computer definitions, it is out of my range. There is only one solution. I can just click on the form, and when I increase that one, you can see that one, that label is available. But how can I increase the size of form as per my need? So the concern is that, is there any provision that I can visualize all the computer definition and whatever the write down in a computer? Yes. So I select it. Label is selected. Now I go to auto size. I make it false. By default, it is true. But when I make it false, you can see that one, that is 6 dots are available in my label. Now I am increasing it. Look. And when I increase it, oh, very nice. Now, computer is an electronic machine that perform not only numerical process, but it provides logical argument and make program to solve our various tasks. So auto size false. You can make your label so customized, you can do it as per things. Now, if I want to do it like font size, I always go for a 12. That's a 12 is a standard size. And when I make it font size 12, it is somewhat readable. So this is an auto size property of a label. And herewith, I would like to provide a back color property also. I go to back color, in a back color, custom color is there, and I want to give it this light green color. So fine, it's a pista color is there and light green color is affected. This is what about the label, but now we are going to learn about label. There is a very, very, very nice property. And this property is performed dynamically. Today, students, we are going to explore about some two new events about label. So again, toolbox, I drag and drop label. I make it auto size false. So this is the thing. And auto size false, I make this property by font. Would like to increase the size of font, that is 20. Fine. Statically, four color means a font color, custom, red. You can see that one. The label two is making red because four color is a font color. I go to this label two, I would like to remove, and I want to make it Dr. Abhijit Singh Jadeja. Oh, nice. So I would like to accommodate this name here. My default name is here. So friends, this is label two. And now when I double click on it, you know that one, that event generate, base class library generate, private sub, form load event. My form name is label example. So I would like to put one simple message box, MSG box. It's a purple font is available. This is method. In this method, double inverted comma, this is form load event. Thanks. Now, please kindly concentrate because it is a very important topic about label and how we can work on it. So friends, here I go to there, label two. I take it because label one, that computer definition is there and it's a static thing that I perform. Now in label two, I go there and at right side where declarations are there, I move to explore a new event named mouse over. So A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M. And yes, mouse. There are so many event related mouse. Mouse click is there, mouse double click is there, mouse down is there, mouse enter and mouse hover. When I click on it, look, this event generated automatically. Label 2 underscore mouse hover private sub and sub is there. Now, I would like to do one property, that is label 2 dot text. Look, and in a double inverted comma, A. This is mouse over event. I go for a label two again. Dot back color equal to color dot red. Label two dot four color. Four color means a font color equal to color dot white. Fine. I think this is more than enough. So this is label two mouse hover event. This is label two is there. And now I would like to go for mouse leave event. So I scroll for mouse leave event. And here mouse over. After mouse over, mouse leave event is there. When I click there, that event generated. Now I make a copy of it. I paste this. This is mouse hover event. Instead of that, mouse L-E-A-V, leave event, mouse out of label, not white, but I make it green. And friends, let me start to run this program. For run any program, you know very well, I need to go to Solution Explorer, I go to project, right click, property, startup form is select case example, that was our previous program, but this is the label example that we create here right now. I click on this, I close this, After tools menu, this is a play button, or you can press F5. It is indicated start debugging. When I click on it, look, my friends, it's a very nice program. This is form load event. Before form load, this message box come from label example underscore load. When I press OK, this is my form. By default name, label 2 is Dr. Abhijit Singh Jadeja. But you will see a really very nice magic when I put my mouse over there. Oh, very nice. Hey, this is mouse over event. The color is red. The font color is white. When my cursor is in this label 2, this effect shows me like that. But when I put my cursor out of this label, look very carefully. Oh my God, this is very nice again. Hey, this is mouse leave event, mouse out of label. When I click over here, it is change, out, change. If it is in, hover means when your mouse is into the border of my label 2, it is like that. When I close this and when I move my mouse out of this label, it is green. And when I close it and when I again run this, look, by default label is Dr. Abhijit Singh Jadeja. Of course, yes. Would like to just, when my mouse is there, look what happened. It is red color. Color.white is there. So font color is white. When my mouse is out of it, hey, this is mouse leave event. Mouse out of label. And actually, mouse is out of this label. Mouse. So it's a very fun. And if you kindly observe some websites, whenever you put your mouse into the menu, that menu color is changed, menu is highlighting, menu is having a shadow, font is changing and all that things. So this is a very nice property that we learn. This is a runtime property. Label2.text is a property. And I put a message runtime. When my mouse is on the label, it is hover event. Look, this is mouse hover event. So my message is changed and label back color is changed by red. Label back color, my label 4 color is changed with white. And my mouse is out of the label. It is mouse leave event. Means my mouse is out of the border of label. The message is changed. Hey, this is mouse leave event. Mouse out of label. Here it is that if you want to change the font name, font size and font bold at runtime, how can you do it? It is very easy, my dear friends. Please kindly concentrate. Font equal to new font. Yes, this is a C++ object oriented concept where you declare the object you always use with new keyword. Here also we use new keyword. I am providing the font is Arial. Now comma. EM size single. I'm giving font size is 18, comma. Style. And that metadata shows me font style dot bold, font style dot italic. Look. Here is bold, italic, regular. Please kindly concentrate where pop-up menu is there. I would like to say bold and close. Now the same thing I would like to repeat for mouse leave event. You can see label2.font equal to new font into the bracket. Or I can say that one family of a font. Inverted comma, and I'm giving Times New Roman, comma, the size of font I would like to make it as 20, comma, I would like to make it an underline, close it, and let me check now. Load event is there, of course, yes. I make it small. I put it down over here. Look, the font size is, font name is Arial. and it is 18. When I put my cursor out, oh my God, the font is Times New Roman. The size is, you can see that 20 size is there. You can decrease the size of font, you can increase the size of font. Suppose when my mouse is leave, the font will be very small. So what should I do? I should go for a 12. And when my mouse is there, I would like to increase the font size. Now I just change the font size is there. I repeat it. I execute form load event is run and it shows me the message. This is form load event. Thanks. And I would like to decrease that one. Like to put a label form over here. Look, the size is very bigger because now it's 22. And when my mouse is there, look, the size is very small. The Times New Roman font is there? Of course, yes. The font size is 12. Of course, yes. And it is underlined. Look, hey, this is mouse leave event, mouse out of the label. It means underline effect is there.